One of my hobbies is to collect rocks. I'm not talking about the rocks that you find outside. I'm talking about the rocks or minerals with super cool shapes, colors, and patterns, like amethyst, bismuth, quartz, and copper sulfate. All of these are actually crystals, and you can start your own collection today by making some crystals at home. Are you ready? Then let's get scienced. The crystals we're making today are sugar crystals, which means we can eat them. This is rock candy. It looks awesome and tastes amazing. Check out these close-ups.
Whoa!
They look amazing. To make the rock candy, you will need sugar, empty jars, measuring cups, a saucepan, some more sugar, water, wooden sticks or lollipop sticks, plastic wrap, and food coloring. First, add some water to a jar until it's 5 centimeters from the top. Then add the wooden sticks and leave them in the water for 1 minute. Whilst these are soaking, pour some sugar onto a plate. After a minute, take the wooden sticks, roll them in the sugar, and put them on the side of the plate to dry. Now it's time to make your sugar solution.
Whoa!
Add 3 cups of sugar to your saucepan. There's a real art to adding the sugar without making a mess. I'll learn that one day. Then add 1 cup of water. I'm going to double the recipe to make a few extra pieces of rock candy. I'm adding an extra 3 cups of sugar and an extra cup of water. You'll now need an adult to heat the saucepan on medium heat. Stir the mixture every 30 seconds. Keep heating it until all of the sugar dissolves and the solution turns clear. If it starts to boil, turn the heat down to low and keep stirring. Once the solution is clear, turn off the heat and let it cool for 30 minutes. Whilst it's cooling, get 4 glass jars, make sure they're clean, and add 20 drops of food coloring to each one. I'm using yellow, blue, red, and green. It's been 30 minutes since I turned off the heat. The solution is still pretty hot, so only an adult should do this next part. Pour the sugar solution into each jar really slowly and really carefully. For safety, make sure everyone else stands back. The last step is to take one of these sugar-coated sticks, tap it a few times to get rid of any extra sugar, and then place it in the jar. The stick should be 2.5 centimeters from the bottom of the jar and placed in the middle. Hold it in place with a couple of pegs, cover it in plastic wrap, and then place it in a cupboard. How long does it take the rock candy to form? 1 week. Aww. If I start playing this, I might be halfway done by the time the rock candy's ready. 1 week later. 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It's been 1 week since we started making the rock candy. No time to finish the game. Let's see what they look like.
Whoa! Check out all those sugar crystals. They look amazing.
The last step is to take the sticks out of the jars and put them somewhere to dry.
If crystals have formed on the top of the sugar solution, use a butter knife to carefully break through them in a circle around the stick.
So how does all of this work? Let's pretend these cubes are sugar molecules.
The sugar we buy from the store comes as really small sugar crystals. When we add it to water, the small crystals are broken up into individual sugar molecules. This is known as dissolving. We can keep adding sugar to the water, and it will keep on dissolving until we add too much and no more dissolves. This solution is called a saturated solution. If we heat the solution, more sugar is able to dissolve. Yay! When this cools back down, the sugar can stay dissolved. It now has more sugar dissolved in it than before and is called a supersaturated solution. Some of the sugar doesn't want to be dissolved, but it needs a bit of help to get out of the solution. When we add the stick that was rolled in sugar, the sugar in the solution that doesn't want to be dissolved is able to attach to it. The molecules attach in a neat and orderly way, forming really large sugar crystals, which we call rock candy.
The only thing left to do now is decide if you want to eat them or if you want to keep them. I'll see you next time on Silly Science with Simon.